Hi everyone, my name is Sienna. In this video, we will learn how to place multiple objects in AR and interact with them by using gestures to select, move, rotate, and also scale without any coding. We will be using arfoundation and XR Interaction Toolkit. You can use any version of arfoundation and Unity. First, make sure that you already have all the projects set up, such as the package manager and also the player settings. If you don't have the project set up yet, you can watch my basic setup video. We will use XR Interaction Toolkit to implement the interaction. Go to Window, Package Manager, and then go to Unity Registry, scroll to the bottom, and then install XR Interaction Toolkit. If you get this prompt, because we are installing this package for the first time in this project, just click No Thanks. Then in a new scene, remove the main camera, and then right-click XR, add XR origin. It will also add XR Interaction Manager. XR Interaction Manager is for the interactors and interactables to be able to communicate. The main camera will be added as the child of XR origin game object. For the left-hand controller and right-hand controller, you can see this line here. Because we don't want to see it when using the app, disable the XR interactor line visual. Then we also need to add AR session. Make sure to reset the transform. And then for the app to be able to recognize our gesture, in the main camera, we need to add the AR gesture component. It will automatically add the interaction manager and also the XR origin game object. If you are using the previous version of arfoundation that is still using arfoundation origin, you can just set the arfoundation origin instead of the XR origin. If the XR interaction manager and the XR origin variable are null, Unity will automatically set them when you play the app, so you can leave them as null. AR gesture interactor is a component that translates task events to gestures such as tap, drag, and pins. This is all the available interactable from Unity. You can also extend these packets to define your own gestures. Then to detect the plane in the environment, in XR origin, add AR plane manager component. The plane prefab is what the plane manager will create for its detected plane. Let's use the default plane from Unity. Right-click, XR, AR default plane. Make sure to reset the transform, and then make it as a prefab. Delete the game object in the scene. And then drag and drop this to the plane prefab. You can change the detection mode to choose if you want to be able to track horizontal or vertical or both. Then add AR raycast manager to raycast against the trackable planes. This raycast prefab is to visualize the raycast. Let's just leave it as null. To place objects in the scene, instead of creating a script, we can just add AR placement interactable component. Right-click, XR, AR placement interactable. Change the interaction layer match to everything, so we can interact with any layer. The placement prefab is the game object that will be spawned on the task position when the user tap on the trackable plane. Let's say this is the prefab that we want to spawn. Drag and drop to the placement prefab variable. If you build the project now, if you tap on the trackable plane, you'll be able to place multiple objects on the task position. Then to be able to interact with the spawn object, you can add any interactable component to the spawn object prefab, depending on what kind of interaction you want to do. For example, if we want to be able to move the object, we can add the AR translation interactable component. The selection interactable component will also be added because we need to select the object first to be able to do any interaction with it. Enable the Xcode UI tags, so if you touch on any of the UI, it will block the tags from the game object. If you want the user to be able to see which object is currently being selected, you can add the selection visualization. For me, I will use this outline. So first, create a new material. And then use under transparent, then add the outline image. Then in the spawn game object, add a plant game object. Change the material. Then resize it so it will fit with the spawn game object. And then drag and drop the new game object to the selection visualization variable. In the translation interactable component, you can change object gesture translation to choose if you want to be able to move the object horizontally or vertically or both. Then if you want to rotate the game object, you can add AR rotation interactable. Using AR rotation interactable, there are two ways to rotate the game object. One is by using the user touch gesture. Another one is by doing the drag gesture with the start touch position is outside the selected game object. These two variables is the speed of the game object rotation when using the specified gesture. Then if you want the user to be able to scale the object, add IR scale interactable component. You can modify the minimum and the maximum scale of the game object. I think 0.75 is still too big, so I will change it to 0.5. Let's change all the layer maps to everything. Remember that it's fine if the XR interaction manager and the XR origin variable are null. Don't forget to remove the AR prefab from the scene. Now you can build and test this project. Move your camera around to detect the plane. Then if you tap on any of the trackable planes, the prefab will be spawned. If you tap on any of the spawn prefab, it will be selected. Tap on the same object to deselect it. After you have selected it, if you do a drag gesture on the selected object, you can move it around. If you do a drag gesture outside of the selected object, you can rotate it. Or you can do a twist gesture. If you do a pinch gesture, you can scale it. Thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe and check my Patreon. If you have any question or suggestion, feel free to ask in the comment or in the Discord channel.